Right, so let's head to Parliament now, where the minority in the House has faulted government for increasing expenditure without corresponding sustainable revenue mobilization measures at a news conference in Accra ahead of the 2020 budget presentation. The minority said government has resorted to disingenuous, unconventional and unacceptable ways of hiding expenditures. And Godfrey Tanam has more.
The minority would like to caution the Minister for Finance to desist from such unconventional financial manipulation. He is advised to correct all this fiscal misreporting in the 2020 budget and economic policy of government. The failure to heed this caution and advice, the minority will use all constitutional provisions available to resist this act.
NPP's 2016 manifesto promised to reduce corporate income tax from 25% to 20%. This, the minority says, has not been implemented.
In their 2016 manifesto, the NPP promised to remove both components, the 1% and 2% of the special import levy. They removed the smaller component, which is the 1% in 2016, but then decided to extend the larger component, the 2%, which forms approximately 80% of the levy, to December 2019. Again, we urge the President, through the Minister for Finance, to keep its promise of removing the 2% special import levy in the coming budget.
The minority insists the approach in the financial sector cleanup is the most reckless and inhumane option, which is also contrary to the assurances that depositors' funds will be protected and jobs will be saved.
The minority notes that none of these assurances have been kept. The mess has further aggravated the unbearable hardship Ghanaians are currently experiencing, with the overall negative effect on the larger Ghanaian economy yet to be thoroughly quantified by your government. We expect the finance minister to put out concrete measures to address the non-payment of depositors and salvage jobs in the last budget of the Akufo-Addo government.
The minority insists the Ghanaian economy has been largely characterized by deteriorating standard of living of the average Ghanaian, increasing cost of utilities and transportation, collapse of businesses, among others, in the past 3 years.